What up, what up, what up? CPA Strength, strongest CPA in Florida, back again. This is the classic series, man. You know what it is. AFB, Accounting for Beginners, number 28, 28. You know what it is. Come on, let's go, let's get it in. Assets, what are assets? I know I just did a whole bunch of videos as increased assets. CPA Strength, you should have put these before the other ones, I know, but my mind's a jumbled mess and I'm not perfect, and I'd rather just show out and put videos out instead of try to be perfect and not have enough videos out. Let's go. What is an asset? So first, I know you've been studying. Look, if this is your first one, welcome. I'm gonna put a up here, my playlist, best accounting playlist on the interwebs. Just saying, I'm a little biased, but you know what it is. I know you have your DCA Adler. I know you already have that. What is DCA Adler? Debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue. And you know all these are in the normal balances. So if you notice, we have six, one, two, three debits, one, two, three credits in the normal balance, the positive balance. I have done, I think, Accounting for Beginners number 18. We'll put a card up here, was on draw. Today, we're doing what is an asset. We're concentrating on one of the six boxes that a transaction could be in. It is asset today. Great. Assets, very important. As you can see, assets equal liabilities plus equity. So I'm starting with assets right now. It's number 28. Next video, we're gonna do liabilities, and the next one after that is gonna be what is equity. Now, assets equal liabilities plus equity. That is the balance sheet. Assets equal liabilities plus equity is the balance sheet. So that's why we're gonna take these on first, and then we're gonna have the balance sheet, which is also, see, look. This, DCA Adler, and you know this always equals. So there's the balance sheet in DC Adler. But, and also assets equal liabilities plus equity. It's also called the basic accounting equation. Now if you're taking this in school, you're probably gonna say, what's the basic accounting equation? What's the basic accounting equation? And to be honest, I don't even know why that matters really after school. Because, like, assets equal liabilities and equity, it is the basic accounting equation, but I don't tell, like, my clients, or I'm not in QuickBooks going, oh, it's the basic accounting equation. I say, oh, it's the balance sheet. Now, the balance sheet is, in my opinion, the most important financial statement. I need a balance sheet, and I need an income statement every year to do the tax returns. So what's it all about anyways, right? Making money and paying them taxes. So, and the balance sheet is on the top because that is reused every single year, updated every single year, every single year. The income statement is just for that period of time, just for that 1 year. And whatever happens on that goes over to the balance sheet. But, so balance sheet is super important, super important. In accounting, it's the basic accounting equation is assets equal liabilities plus equity. So all three of these are super, super, super important. But let's think about this now. If on one, if they equal, it's a balance, so it balances. A balance sheet, right? One half of it's the assets. So, and on the other half, there's two things, liabilities and equity, liabilities and equity. So, this must be pretty important. It seems to be the basis of everything, assets, okay? The definition of the book says, assets. What is an asset? So resources owned by a business. Thanks a lot. All right, so resources owned business. I would say almost, instead of, you know, resources owned by a business. Oh shit, I'm blinking. I'm almost out of battery. I want to finish up. So it's resources owned by a business. What do? Businesses want to make money. Now we're just going to go through common assets that would be in here on a journal entry. Common assets. Cash or checking account. Alright, so now we're gonna go on mine. Now cash, it's like, okay, cash is like chippers, like Scrooge McDuckish, or your checking account. Now, you have some money or money in a checking account. Can I make more money with it? Because businesses want to make money. Is this gonna help me make more money? Yes, it is. Make more money, make more money, make money, make them chippers, get their money! Yes, this is gonna help me make money. Equipment. I got equipment, I got a laptop, I got a printer. Is that gonna help me make more chippers? Yes, it's an asset, it's a resource I own, I'm getting more chippers. Accounts receivable. Someone owes me chippers, so I can go make more chippers with them chippers, yo! So yes, accounts receivable. Asset. Loan to Mr. Never Pay Me Back. I loaned somebody, he says he's gonna pay me back, he ain't never gonna pay me back. But if he did, I would have more chippers so I can make more chippers. I got cash so I can make more cash. So a loan to somebody who ain't never gonna pay me back, and no one ever pays you back. That's an asset. Inventory. I got products, man, I got products. I got widgets out the door. So I'm gonna sell these widgets to get more money so I can go make more money. So that's an asset, it's a resource. Yeah, inventory, yeah. Land, building. I got a building. I own a building on some land, and with this building, I got all my stuff going on. I'm gonna make more money. I'm gonna get more money so I can go spend it and make more money. Yeah, money. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked it, hit a like, because it helps me more than you would know to have the video reach a wider audience. Leave a comment for future questions. Anyways, I can't believe it. I am at, right now, almost 18,000 subscribers, which is crazy. I think this is the first time I might have talked about subscribers on my YouTube page. It's growing rapidly. I could have never imagined how many people that I would be helping throughout the whole world. And I think when I get to 20,000, I might do a thank you, or I just talk about the 20,000.